along with Tim Hardaway, Slam Jam and Sonics, Gary Payton and the Rainman, Sean Kemp.
The Rainman!
Supermodels Nikki and Chrissy Taylor. The Suns Thunder, Dan Marley.
Oh,
Rookie of the Year, Chris Webber. Kennedy and the Knick City Dancers. Grandmama Larry Johnson. MTV's NBA Slam and Jam Wrap-Up.
That's what you're gonna see. Nothing but great action this whole hour. I'm Bill Bellamy, and welcome to MTV's NBA Slam and Jam Wrap-Up. In this hour, you're gonna get a chance to see some of the hottest stars of the NBA, baby. And it ain't no joke. So let's get it started right now. Hey.
He passed the paint, 2-on-1.
Can you believe it? It is true. I'm in Seattle, and I'm hanging out with the dynamic duo of the Seattle Supersonics, Gary Payton.
Hey, unbelievable.
Sean Kemp.
Kemp going to the hoop. Wow.
The disaster team right here. Boom!
Here's Payton loops it ahead for Kemp. And flushes it down!
Now, how do y'all hook up like that on the court? Just you find my man like that, G?
Before, you know, we got the season started, he said, hey, you go throw it up, you throw it off the backboard, I go get it. So I just
it's
throw
like
it
that.
Up there. It's like that.
I don't care. I mean, it ain't no ball too high for you, man, that you can't grab?
Not too high, especially on a run. You come down that runway off
Ooh,
the side.
On the runway.
Get on the magic carpet and run!
Run!
Look out.
I love highlights, fellas. I'm telling you. But you know who? Every time I look at highlights, I always see Tim Hardaway. He's always in there. Even though he ain't played this year, you know, he's a little hurt, whatever, like that. But we have to go to Tim Hardaway and see what he thinks, because I know he got about the best plays of the year. Want to check him out?
Yeah, I know one thing.
What?
We better be
yeah.
up in there.
You think so?
Yeah, I know we going to be
there. Most definitely. I know he's got me at least two or three of them in there.
Let's find out.
Yeah, and it goes, and it goes, and then it goes a little something like this. Hit it!
Yeah!
Yo, what's up, what's up? Tim Hardaway from Golden State Warriors.
Tim Hardaway behind the back. He spins and scores.
I did not play this year due to injuries, but I kept my eye on the NBA this whole season.
Look at this. Day at the beach.
So let's show some highlights. And let's start it off with some dunks.
Hey, coast to coast. Ryder goes up high. Passing.
Hey, Sean. Come on, baby. Don't let me down.
Here's Cam.
Oh, the big dunk.
Those dunks were nice, but I'm partial to the little man. So let's check out the little people dunk on the big people.
Ooh, in your face, Kevin Johnson!
All the way! How about that? Get out of your seat on that one!
Those were some pretty sweet moves. But defense wins championships. Everybody knows that.
Play some defense. Push them.
I like to move it, move it. Ewing, please check the fire, Ryder.
Nobody got back on defense. Robert Horry blocks the shot. Blocks it again.
Williams against Ellis.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Out on the break, and Perkins blocked by Rodman.
Rodman is a force around the basket. But what's up with his hair?
You're so wild, you're so unique. Everybody calls you the beauty freak.
Get all that hair stuff. Let's get back to basketball. Check out these crazy shots.
I bring it like that and then I'm swinging.
Payton, one of that number.
Oh, the shot by Payton goes.
Box in the lane with a float.
Oh,
and now Ryder. Watch.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know I like buzzer beaters. Check out the buzzer beaters this season.
3, 2, 1.
1 second, did he get it in time? Yes! Yes! Count the basket!
Myers triggers the inbound. Kukoc for the win!
That's it for the plays of the year. I'm Tim Hardaway.
Man, I can't believe this in Seattle. All this sunshine.
Hey! Moonlight.
What with the
good
boogie?
Time.
Hey, but the boogie. Yo, man, I'm telling you, Seattle is about music, though. I like it out here, man. It's kind of cool. You even got a chance to hang out with Pearl Jam.
Oh, yeah, they're from Seattle also. You know, we did a couple charity games together last year, made a poster together and sold them around town and stuff.
They had a whole lot of fun, man. Yeah. And what about your show? I know you have a lot of fun on your show.
Oh, yeah, you know, I just kick it with the fellas, man. I try to get all my boys off the team to come in there.
Hey, what's up? The glove is gone, and I'm gone. Bow wow. Whoop, whoop.
You ain't 7'1", man. 6'9".
Well, right now, I want to give you an opportunity to kick to this feature. Why don't you do that for me? Show them how you do, G.
Oh, you check it out. This is how I'm going to do it. When I be in my show, I be like, look here. You know, this is Gary Payton, the glove from Seattle, just hanging out. Y'all know how I be throwing them alley-oops. I throw the lob, and then Sean come with the jam. Now, you know what? Next is NBA jams. Huh, come get with us.
Yeah.
In effect.
Yo, you want to know what kind of music we listen to in the NBA? Well, check this out.
I like to listen to jazz, mellow music, hip-hop.
Street music.
The blues.
I had to have rap music. Rap music. I love all types of rap music. If you
meet me. I like ballads.
I like country music.
Country western?
I think of Travis Tritt, a great country music singer.
Play a lot of reggae.
R&B. Smooth out with a little hip-hop.
Guns N' Roses, Skid Row. I'm a big heavy metal fan.
This is for all you headbangers out there.
We're live. This is Tolbert Television.
And as of late, I've gotten into, you know, a little rap here and there. Ice-T.
You know who you are.
I just love Chuck D and Queen Latifah. I can go on forever about, you know, rap music.
You got a jam before we play.
Sometimes it's the beats. Okay, give me a few seconds first. I give a shot to every jersey born in redhead. And sometimes it's just the lyrics. Who got my back? Jersey got your back. Don't tell me who got my back. LeBron got your back.
If you know something about music, you really appreciate a culture.
We have some things to offer rappers just like they have things to offer us. Oh,
yeah. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Do you want me to shoot it?
I'm a basketball player slash rapper, and do you hear me rapping? I do throw a little basketball terms in there, because that's how the world knows me, as a basketball player.
Oh my God, what is that? Lumpfish?
Where are we, fellas?
Here we are in Seattle at the famous fish market.
Oh, check this out.
Right here.
You guys do everything perfect playing ball. I wonder if y'all could do this thing right here with the fish, man. You think you can rock it? I don't know.
Man, I can rock it. Check it. Sean, tell him what's up.
Ain't nothing he can throw I can't hold.
Well, let's see. Get down to them. Go. You ready? You catch it now.
Oh,
go ahead.
Come on, Sean, give me one for the road, baby. One for the road.
Ah! Yeah, boy, that caught a good one.
Yo, thanks a lot, fellas, for letting me come down here and hang out with you in Seattle. But I want to show you something from my boy Sean Kemp. It's Pearl Jam with GOAT. And I got to go with this fish.
Not a TV studio. Turn these lights out. Ready to stand up.
What a play! The Rain Man has struck.
coming up next. Phoenix Suns' Dan Marley, supermodels Nikki and Chrissy Taylor, and MVP Hakeem Olajuwon.
Hey, we're back right here at the City by the Bay, San Francisco. I know you're ready for the tour. Come on. Woo! Rice and Roni, the San Francisco treat. The world-famous Chinatown. Got a little something in your nose there.
San Francisco.
This city really has it going on. The City by the Bay. But the man who has the city by storm is none other than Chris the Man Weber. Right there, Big Daddy.
Oh, what a play by Weber.
What's up, boy? I can't believe you home. What's up, man?
Can I
use your bathroom?
Yeah, come on. Yeah.
I've been running around all day. Wow. Oh, man. Man, this is beautiful, Chris.
Thanks,
yo,
man.
I'm proud of
Thanks
you, man. I had a studio apartment like this one time. I'm telling you, you got to take me on the tour so I can see, you know, just saying.
I'll take you on the tour, right, man. Cool. Just don't touch nothing.
What?
Be careful. Just don't touch
nothing. All right, cool. Man, what is this? Holy cow.
My jacuzzi. You know, after the games, you be a little sore.
Uh-huh. Yeah, right. This ain't nothing but some pumps and a bump, and it's all good.
Uh-huh.
Please don't make that shot. Damn. Kind of nice, man.
Thanks, bro.
I know, man. I got to get it to you. This house is wonderful, too, man. What was it like being a rookie, though, man?
It was hard, man. You know, we had to pay our dues, but, you know, hopefully one day I'll be up there with the big fellas. You know,
you all right with me, Webb.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, you good, man. You good, man. Let me beat you with some pool real quick. But, yo, you know what? It's a lot of other rookies in the league. People probably wondering how they did. So we got something for you. We got the Rookie Real World. Y'all should check that out.
This is the true story of three NBA rookies
who agreed to have their lives taped
to find out what happens when the game's in and real life begins.
The Rookie Real World. My name is Lindsey Hunter, and I play guard for the Detroit Pistons.
All right. What's up, what's up?
This is Jack, my pal. He's growing a mustache.
What's up?
I'm in a fantasy land doing something I love to do and get paid.
Lindsey Hunter. Oh! Exciting young player.
How you doing, man? I'm Lindsey Hunter, best friend and his agent, so I'm getting like 15% of his money.
But on the serious side, man, he's the next Isaiah Thomas, man.
I want to be just like him when I grow up.
My name is Nick Van Exel, and I play guard for the Los Angeles Lakers.
Say hi, Nick.
Oh, man.
Maybe Nick's in a bad mood.
Van Exel, the runner. My goodness, this rookie has come to the fore.
You got to come in with the right attitude, have a lot of confidence, and you just got to keep your head up when times go tough for you. My name is Calvert Cheney, and I play guard for the Washington Bullets.
Show me the game, baby.
Oh, no. And we love Calvert. We really do. We love you, Calvert.
Great rookie show here. Cheney fires. He is putting on a show.
Well, as soon as I got here, you know, they took me in, and everything was real nice. And as the year went on, I mean, I felt, you know, like one of the guys.
It's down at the end of the long street. I get so lonely.
Take it, Cal.
I get so lonely. I could not.
At the Hollywood Athletic Club, kicking it. I got skills for the earthquake victims in South Central LA.
I think it's pretty fun. The guys who make a lot of money and guys who are always seen as role models or projected as role models should go out and, you know, give back to communities.
So I do the suckers on the basketball court. Break them off something proper.
With so much drama in the air we see, it's kind of hard being Snoop D-O-double-G, but I somehow, some way.
Hello?
Lindsey?
Yes.
Hi, it's Barbara. How are you?
Oh, how are you?
You know how that is.
Well, how'd you guys do last night?
We did okay. Yeah, we won last night.
You get a little more attention than you normally would, you know, but that's why I try to stay home a lot.
Here's my little girlie.
You know, my dog is, her name's Sybil. She's a Siberian Husky, and she's 6 months old right now.
Look at that innocent face. Look at that.
She's a little pest.
Hey. Where you going?
There's one time where she locked herself in the bathroom, and she, poo-pooed on the floor. I about killed her.
Have any certain players, like, try to give you, like, that rookie introduction to the league?
Well, they got me carrying bags, off the bus. I mean, every time I had to shoot around, man, they got me, they throw the ball up in the stands, man. I got to go chase them down.
Calvin.
They told me I'm not a veteran yet until the first game of next year.
Really, it ain't no good part of being a rookie. It's all tough.
That's being a rookie. You know, you have to take your bumps and your bruises. So if you just give your heart and soul to it, you know, you'll get some good things out of it, and that's what I'm trying to do.
I wish Chris Webber would come out here messing with me.
Hey, yo, Bill, what's up,
man? Hey, man. Yeah, right. How you doing? Yeah, right. I was just playing on the court for you. How long you been over there?
I just came out.
Oh, cool. Glad he didn't hear me. Anyway, man, I mean, you played this season, man. It was pretty tough. What was, like, the best, I mean, the hardest team you played all year long?
I'd probably say Seattle.
Houston. They good. Houston.
And then, the Pistons. Where I'm from, Detroit, so they got to play us hard.
Man, what's up with New York, though, man? You ain't even say New York. We coming hard.
They all right.
What you mean? Hey, you want to see how tough New York is? Check out Kennedy behind the scenes with the Knicks. Man, you better represent
Detroit.
One-on-one, baby.
Hello, it's Kennedy, and we are here in Madison Square Garden in the bowels of MSG, and we're trying to figure out what goes on behind the scenes at one of those lovely NBA games. You know what I'm saying? And look, there are the Knick City Dancers. I could do that. Oh, no problem. Wait! I could easily be a Knick City Dancer. That's all it takes to be a dancer? No problem. Pop prep limo, I can do that.
That's easy? You can easily be a dancer?
No problem. I can do that with my eyes closed, Derek. I can do that. I could be a Knick City Dancer.
Oh, really?
Come on now. What's so tough about being a dancer?
You don't think it's so tough? You're going to become a Knick City Dancer.
Just wait. First night of rehearsals here. Kennedy trying to be a Knick City Dancer, okay? Now, I want to kindle some sisterhood with these people and try and create a little bit of magic. Want to be a Knick City Dancer. Want to make a good first impression. Want to belong. They've already started. I'm late. Here we go. Ready? And Kennedy, you ready? Come, baby, Shiki's little practice. Dance class couldn't hurt. I'll show you the hardest part of this whole thing. That's the hardest part of the whole thing.
I hope she's not dancing with us.
She drinks a lot of water. We work with her a couple weeks. We could whip her up.
Welcome to Madison Square Garden, the world's most famous arena.
The big night has finally arrived. I am on the floor in Madison Square Garden, and the world can see me tonight. All my hard work is going to pay off, and everyone will know that I was born to be here at Madison Square Garden. I'm a Knick City Dancer.
Patriot, I got to go out there. Kennedy, what are you doing? What are you doing?
What are you talking about?
You are not dressed.
Oh, no, I thought I'd wear something different so I could stand out since it's my big night.
Kennedy, you're not going out like that. Get back there and put on your uniform. Your uniform.
Yo, come on, move this.
Okay, 5 and 6 and 7 and eight.
Whoa.
What are you doing? I have to go out there and dance.
Not this uniform.
This uniform. It's perfect.
Oh, yeah.
You are ready. Now that's what a Knick City Dancer looks like. So, but you gotta go.
Okay.
One second.
I'm going.
Go, go, go,
I'm going.
Go,
Patriot. Go,
go,
go, Kennedy.
Ready?
Nothing will stop me from being a Nick City dancer.
She's a maniac, maniac on the floor. And she's dancing like she's never danced before. She's a maniac, maniac on the
floor. Oh, yeah, man. Yeah, yeah. See, I'm getting there. I'm getting there. Yo, I like to thank you personally for letting me come out of crib,
nice
hang out
there
in the studio, man. This is what you do. You relax, come up and play with the music.
Oh, yeah, I got to listen to a lot of music, man. Relax after the game.
Yeah, this is kind of cool, man. You know what? I've been doing everything. I want you to tell them what we got coming up, Chris.
Okay. Coming up next, we got Rosala. And are you ready to fly?
Yeah. Hold on.
And check out Bill getting nice on the turntable.
Are you ready to fly?
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 Are you ready for me?
An explosion by Chris Webber.
Coming up next, Cindy Crawford, Grandmama Larry Johnson, and Dougie Fresh.
We need to go through a workout together. You want to hit it a little bit?
Huh?
Want to hit it?
Yeah, man, sure.
Let's go hit it. All right, Bill. This for the pecs, baby. We
right.
Need this. Let's
I got you, baby. I got you. I ain't going to let you down. Oh, yeah. I'm
right,
ready.
Here we go. Here we
all
go.
Right, ready?
Yep.
You ready?
Yeah.
You ready?
Hit that thing.
I'm ready.
Okay.
All right.
Lightweight. Bill? Bill?
Hey, man. Come on, brother. Help me out, man.
What's going on? Man?
Yeah.
Come on, Bill. 50 more.
Yeah.
Two. Bill. Come on, baby.
I'm telling you, LJ, I'm getting big, baby.
Bill.
I'm getting big.
Don't kill yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Don't do it, Bill. No. You don't have the pecs. You don't have the trial.
Come on, man.
Don't do it. You got style, though, Bill. This shirt is hitting.
Thank you.
Sweet. You got style. Cindy Crawford's NBA House of Style. Check it out.
I got style. I know that. I'm getting big. I don't care what shape.
No.
I'm getting big!
Every NBA player knows the three things that matter in pro ball: size, strength, and speed.
What a block! What a big fella!
He's a giant among giants.
Wow! Power! Extraordinaire! What a move! Oh, did he explode and it goes! That was brilliant!
But for me, there's a fourth element that determines the true superstars: style.
You got style.
The NBA's most notorious clothes horses are often featured in fashion magazines.
Fashion, turn left, fashion, turn left.
And the lucky ones get to hang with supermodels. So let's see who's hip and hop in this special edition of House of NBA Style.
Best dressed guys in NBA, Kevin Willer.
Akeem.
Well, thank you.
I give it to Kendall Gill. Kendall Gill's a good dresser as well.
Gotta look neat. Always.
Dominique Wilkins.
Me. I'm the best dresser in the league. It's a.
The players aren't the only slick dressers. Sometimes it's the big man himself, the coach, who earns best dressed honors. A head coach must possess confidence, leadership, and poise.
That's what I'm talking about!
Plus, he's got to look the part.
Always laughing,
Whether he's trying to work the refs or motivate his players, image is everything.
Chuck Daly frantically searching for something that works.
Every girl crazy about a shine as me.
So when a coach molds a team in his image, what's really on the line is his own sense of style.
I am aware of those kind of things.
Listen, get in here!
I think most guys in the league can really dress when they want to. Most of the guys, you know, they're so slim and tall that they can't help but look good.
I'm too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy for my shirt. So sexy it hurts.
But even these stylish superstars have pulled a few fashion faux pas.
Let's go.
Let's see what skeletons or other scary items might be hiding in their closets.
There was a jacket that was made for me back in college that I'd never wear because if I did wear it, I would get laughed out of the locker room.
A black patent leather suit that I made like 3 years ago. I wore it once and I haven't worn it since. I got kind of scared of it a little bit.
I have a bunch of ties that I can't even give away. I mean, back then they were hip, you know, but now, with me caught dead in them.
You look marvelous. Absolutely marvelous.
So that's it for style from the NBA world.
What's up, Diddy? What do you think? Think
definitely
I'm the best guy in the NBA?
Definitely
what do
best.
You think?
Yeah, right. Back to you, Bill.
So, man, you do the weight training thing. I guess we got to do a little running now, huh?
Oh, you got to do some running.
Yeah, okay, that's cool. I like that, man. I just want to let you know I run a 4.240.
Yeah,
man, my boys call me Rocket. Don't let that scare you, Larry. Don't let it scare you.
Rocket?
Come on, man, you got to get ready for this. I want to see what you got.
I don't know if I know.
Yeah, you need to tie your shoes.
Oh, my shoes untied?
Yeah.
Let me get my
shoes. Yeah!
Yes. Come on, Bill. Bill.
Whoa.
Rocket. Come on, Bill. What happened to you, Rocket?
I got a bad fuse, boy.
Woo.
Listen, man. You blew by me. That's all right,
yeah.
Though, man.
Yeah.
Listen, I got my boy to hook me up. We got a music video for y'all right now. Dougie Fresh with the NBA's all right. All right. I'm all right.
You got Bill all right, too.
I'm all right.
Let's run 100.
What? You
got to get another
You must
100.
Be crazy. Crazy, boy. Yeah, LJ, this is basketball, baby. I know you 6'7", 260, dream team too. You beat me in everything today. I don't care, man. You beat me in the weight room, beat me in the track. This ball, this man game. Come on, baby. You ain't got nothing for me. I'm check. Wait a minute. Hold on, man.
Paramedic.
Help me up, brother.
Come on. I got you.
I didn't know you was that bad.
Yeah, I know.
No, I must have got sucked in the draft.
The draft got you.
When you blew by me. My leg got sucked right in there.
Now
you ain't even stop either.
No, I dunk.
That's how you do
now
it?
Now I come back and see you.
All right, man, I thanks for everything, though, man. You let me hang out with you for a whole day and everything.
No problem.
Can you show me that movie,
anytime,
man?
Off camera.
Off camera. All right, yo.
Never
we'll
know your stuff.
We will be back and stuff, man, but I can play other things.
Ping pong.
I'm good, man. I'm telling you, man.
Ping
I got a shirt.
Ping pong.
I got a shirt.
Ping pong.
I'm playing, man.
Coming up next, a look inside the NBA playoffs.
We're in New York City. This is the place of the finals. Can you believe it? Five of the best players on this side. Five of the best players on that side. Get on the paint. Get busy for four quarters for the big, big trophy here at the Garden. That's where it should be. And you know what? Just so I let you know how my fans feel about the intensity here, I'm going to let you see what playoff intensity is about. We're going to talk to some fans from the street and let you know what is happening. Check it out.
And who was your favorite player to play?
Charles Oakley. Can't you tell?
Excuse me. Do you like the NBA?
Yeah.
You have an accent. Where are you from?
Brazil.
You have to know about the playoffs in Brazil. You like the playoffs in Brazil?
Yes, they love NBA in Brazil.
Ooh. Well, then, you know what? Have you ever been to a playoff game?
No, I've met him.
Oh, I got to get you there. You have to be there. You know what? Just for my friend here from Brazil, I have got to show her the best of the sights and sounds of the playoffs. You are going to love it. I promise you, I'll put you right on the court. Right there, sitting. Courtside, Spike Lee, and the rest of them.
Okay, buddy. Start playing.
Welcome to the playoffs.
The whole atmosphere is just going to be tremendous.
Unbelievable energy and activity.
Just a wild, wild game.
Kukoc for the win!
You can't get ready to play these kind of games, you know, you're in the wrong business.
Bang your head! Come on! Bang your head! Bang your head!
Myers to Green.
Well, it's a group bang. It's got a funk.
So you got chances to take the ball right to the rim. I'm taking right to the rim.
All right.
Dark reverse. What a shot.
Josh. I am the way of perfection.
The clock straight high. What a look by Greg Anthony.
I am the new way to go. I am the way of the future.
In your face, Kevin Johnson. Oh, my. Robinson over Malone.
Make your best play. I don't care if we messed up.
Now let's find the rhythm. We haven't got a rhythm yet down at the far end.
Myers cross court. Scotty! Oh!
Oh, and he went right over the top of him.
We will find a way to win this game. It's tied at 108. 32.9 remaining. Carl, 20 footer. Ainge is on Thorpe. Thorpe manhandles him, throws it up for two. The Rockets are just stampeding the Phoenix Suns. The Houston Rockets on their way to the Western Conference Finals. They're hugging each other on the Indiana benches. Messi hits a three. For the first time in the history of this franchise, they are going to go to the Eastern Conference Final. It's a great chapter in Pacer history.
Shot clock at 7.
Yes, 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 that was it. That's what I'm talking about, making you feel a part of the playoffs. But listen, the only thing that I'm upset about, man, I'm just a little perturbed here, is because nobody's talking about the All-Star moment, man. We're talking about All-Star weekend, the dunk of the century. Check it out. Man, that's not the dunk I'm talking about. I'm talking about a dunk where stuff gets busy, where you show vertical.
Ladies and gentlemen, buckle up! What a finish! Oh, Big Bill!
Yes, that is how you end the show. I mean, going out with a bang. That's what Bill Bellamy's all about. And right now, I just like to thank everyone who made this such a great show. Exciting, a lot of fun to do. All the players, I'd like to thank Larry Johnson. What's up, baby? Chris Webber, Sean Kemp, Gary Payton, Dan Marley. I'd like to thank Nikki and Chrissy Taylor. I'd like to thank Cindy Crawford and Big Daddy Shaq in the house. And you for watching it. We'll see you next year. Peace.
Watch that man.
They shouldn't have traded Dominique like that.
Don't do that.
Oh, baby. I got it. Come on, lady. She don't want to try me.
He doesn't want any part of me.
You got to come here to eat, baby. I'm telling you.
You're failing me.
You all right?
You all right.
Yeah, you look at it.
Let's run this again, Rocky. Yeah.